So the end of, I was talking about like the, oh yeah, so I was like, I'm going to be completely terrified of high school, except fucking 9/11 happened 3 days into my, freshman year of high school, and I completely forgot about fear of bullies. I was like, we're going to war.
Yeah, bigger and, things were there to be scared of.
It was like shattered my whole understanding of history. I thought history was over. I thought we were done.
Yeah.
And it just like happened.
Yeah, we got computers now. Everything's fucking finished.
But yeah, so my idea, my thesis on this is like now we're so burdened by so much information. It's like we have gout of the mind. And it's like our brains, our emotions are inflamed by information and we're just like blind with fucking rage over things we have no control over whatsoever. Because we have like king knowledge, but we don't have king power.
I like that. I like that. That's a good way to phrase it. But I feel like I focus in on exactly what I want knowledge of. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Maybe that helps because I smoke weed.
Yeah.
And I'm able to like, sometimes it doesn't help, but sometimes it does help. Like I'm just able to, I mean, I'm talking about fucking looking up heights of mountains. You know what I mean? Like nothing fucking pertinent. Yeah. But it's the information that I like to know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But I'm at a bar and somebody's talking about fucking national parks. That's the guy I want to go talk to. You know?
That's the thing is, like, you go on the internet, you're being inundated with all this information and news about things that you have no control over.
Yeah.
And it literally, it makes you feel powerless. And people get angry because they feel powerless about things they don't have anything, they can't do anything about it. But they're just trying, it's like, it's literally, I feel like it's like, it's weird on the internet, man. People just go on there and just fucking tell blatant lies, and then people argue about it underneath the lie and get mad at people that they'll never see and probably don't even exist. People are
might
furious.
Not even be real. Yeah.
People are furious on their emotions. It's like fucking, it's insane.
I stopped a long time ago.
I blocked so many people. This is what happened to me. This saved me during the pandemic. Like literally like a month into the shutdown, I got tired of everyone, and I started blocking people on Facebook that I was like, I'm not sure who these people are.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Because you like, we accept so many friend requests of people under the pretense that we think that they're comics or, like, comedy people, and they're really just political bots. And or they're people that are, like, they're, like, tangentially associated with comedy,
or
but they really
fans.
But all they do is just share political stuff and get into political arguments, and I was like, I'm getting
it's
rid of all these
one
people.
One post.
Yeah.
Policy with me, and then you're fucking...
Then you're out.
Yeah. Well, just unfollow.
Yeah. But like
I remain friends, but do not see...
Yeah, I've done that, too. But I blocked, like, 200 people on my birthday in 2020. Yeah, it was my birthday present to myself. And literally, like, two or three weeks later, the entire fucking world exploded after the George Floyd thing.
Good timing.
I remember, like, waking up the next morning after the George Floyd riots.
Yeah.
And it was like the first thing I opened up my phone, I turned on Twitter. The first thing I see is this video. It's like this white woman, she's like in a motorized wheelchair outside of a Target and she's trying to block people from looting the Target.
I saw
and
that.
Somebody
dude.
Fucking sprays her with a fire hydrant. and I'm like, I'm watching this. I'm like, what is going on? Dude. And then you just hear someone in the background is like, Lydia, is that enough? Is that enough, Lydia? Have you had enough? And I'm just like, who is that?
How does he know his lady's
How
first name?
Know her name?
That rules, though.
It was like, I woke
Some
up to that.
Some random fucking wheelchair Karen trying to defend a Target for no reason.
I woke up to that, and I was like, what the fuck is going on in America? I was like, I thought everybody was at home. I thought we were all supposed to be at home.
That was the pop-off for a fun summer.
Yes. Pop off. It's pop off. Did you ever drink pop off?
I'm sure at one point.
That'll get you inflamed.
Yeah. That'll have you. Right now, if I smell a bottle of pop off, my foot would hurt.
I fucking smell vodka. Oh, my God. I flash back.
No vodka.
The freshman year is bad.
I'm so... It really
it's traumatic.
Makes me happy that I've gotten to a point where it's like, I want to drink this beer specifically.
Yeah.
It's fucking really... It's light. Takes me 10 of them to get drunk.
Yeah.
I'm not going to drink 10 of them tonight.
I don't want to put that much liquid in my body.
I love to pee.
I hate pee.
And then, like, add this amount of weed and maybe a shot of tequila every once in a while, or a margarita. Other than that, I don't like to drink all that shit anymore.
Yeah, well, I'm going to drink today.
Are you?
Yeah.
I want to drink.
Let's go. Let's fucking go. We'll see where we go. Yeah. So, yeah, this is, thank you, John, for coming on with me. This has been a fun convo.
Dude, thanks for having
me. Always fun fucking chatting with you, John. We got
to
do
this.
Yeah,
I love to see you.
Yeah. You got anything coming up? What do you got to promote?
When's this come out?
We'll see. I'm not good at this.
I got a podcast called Little Stinkers that I do with my buddies.
Yeah, you and Mike Rainey?
Mike Rainey and Jake Matera.
I'm scared to listen to your podcast. An episode about some stuff where I was like, I don't want to hear about that guy again. Because he used to read about the fucking...
Yeah, it's about, like, killers.
Yeah, the one guy...
something funny.
I don't know how funny some of this shit is. Charles Manson, I guess he's a silly guy.
Did you guys do Goose?
Rainey's post about Eileen Wuornos, I fucking, I snorted all over my computer screen when he was like, "Bad bitch alert!" Fucking Eileen Wuornos, I fucking snorted.
He loves serial killers. Yeah. Every episode, we flip a coin to see if we're gonna do an episode about the Impractical Jokers, which is what I think Little Stinkers are. Or a crazy serial killer, and so far Mike has won every single coin toss.
Did you watch Mindhunters?
Was one of them? No.
It was like the serial killer miniseries. It was on Netflix.
I only watched the one where they did it on the Atlanta Olympic bombing.
Oh, that's something else.
It might be something else.
Yeah, that's a funny movie. I got to do a podcast.
There's
about
two
that
of them. There's a
movie.
Netflix original one and...
The Clint Eastwood
one Richard
is hilarious.
Yeah, that one actually rolls.
He's just, I love that documentary because he's like, they're like, can you stop, his lawyer is like, can you stop confessing to crimes you haven't committed to the FBI? And he's like, I like the cops. I like cops.
Yeah, he's fucking great.
He's fucking
great. He's
retarded.
In I, Tonya as well.
Oh, that was really good.
Yeah.
I, Tonya.
That one's a rewatch.
Oh, so many things to fucking get into. All right, well, this was great, John. Let's
Dude,
go
thanks
fucking.
For having me. That was a blast.
Let's go get lit.
Oh,
let's go get some gout.
Gout night, baby.
Thanks for listening in. Have a good night.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I made the fade famous, the chain famous. QB on my chest mask, stainless. Amazing grace, I'm gracefully aging. Without masonry, I made more paper to play with. No rap in my playlist. Sold dimes on my day shift.
Hey, just wanted to let you know I'm recording my debut album at Helium Comedy Club in Philadelphia on January 9th. I'll drop the ticket links in the description. Thank you for listening. Have a good week.